IVM. Intel vPro provides the complete manageability tools to detect, repair, and protect your devices remotely, so your workforce can keep doing what they do best, wherever they're working from. Today, as most employees and IT teams no longer work under the same roof, fixing glitchy PCs and proactively managing the PC fleet has become increasingly difficult. The Intel vPro platform addresses these problems. With its Intel Active Management technology, Intel AMT, vPro enables IT to keep mission-critical resources running by establishing a secure connection between IT and an Intel vPro platform-based PC. In the event of a cyber attack, Intel AMT lets IT remotely manage and repair systems simultaneously. Even if they are dispersed across multiple locations, PCs can be quickly recovered, wherever they may be. Plus, the Intel Endpoint Management Assistant, Intel EMA, enables cloud-based manageability using simple web-based tools to connect with and remediate any Intel vPro platform-based PC. Both these tools provide better manageability and faster response times, resulting in substantial device management support, cost savings, and fewer help desk tickets. Visit www.intel.in/itheroes to know more. Intel vPro, built for business. You are the most valuable investment you will ever make. Hi, I'm Zarina Poonawalla, your leadership coach, life coach, and emotional intelligence coach. You probably know me from the Empowering series, and this is my new show, The Life Manifesto with Zarina Poonawalla. I'm going to coach you to be the best version of yourselves. So get ready to create, attain, and manifest the life you've always desired and make it your reality. Hello and welcome to The Life Manifesto with me, Zarina Poonawalla. And I'm quite excited. We're on season 3 and this is episode 2. The last episode we did, episode 1, was all about the 7 golden rules of personal branding. And I really do hope that you managed to put a bit of yours together. So I'm going to do a little extension today. I've come across a lot of audiences, a lot of conversations about personal branding, and there was something very intriguing about them. And I thought it deserved a little bit of attention. So in webinars or conferences or conversations about personal branding with audiences, I realized that when I asked this question, what is a personal brand and what do you think makes a personal brand? A large part of the audience will give me a very common answer. And the answer is something on the lines of, a good personality makes a good personal brand, or if you don't have a strong personality, your personal brand will not work. Now, a lot of people mix personality with personal branding, right? So what do you think? Is your personality the same as your personal brand? Take a moment and process that a bit. You could have a great personality, crisp and smart, well-spoken, well-mannered, but does that necessarily mean that you also have a strong personal brand? I'll tell you what I think. Personality is not the same as a personal brand. No doubt, it does reflect in your personal brand, but it's not the same thing, and it's definitely not directly proportionate to it. There's an interesting fact that I came across recently, and let me share it with you because I found it very fascinating. So 70% people believe that they know how other people feel about them. And only 15% of that is actually true. Fascinating, right? We all tend to believe that we know how people feel about us. But actually, we don't. Only 15% of that is true, and that is so surprising. Now, let me put the same percentage for you in context of personality. So when I think about personality and what people think of me, then I am thinking of the word judgment here. All right? But when I think about this percentage, and I think of the personal brand, then I am not thinking about people's judgments. Then it's basically what people think of your market value, not just monetarily, but the credibility and the reputation that precedes you as a creator and provider of services and products. So you see, what happens is when I use the word personality in perspective of people's thoughts about me, it changes. When I use it regarding the personal brand and people's thoughts about it, it changes. So personality is the package that we create of ourselves. Our characteristic traits, our behavioral patterns, the way we carry ourselves, the way we dress, the way we communicate, our body language, all of that is the pretty package, the personality that we're creating. Whereas personal brand is the package of the product or service, the content that you're creating. So it actually stands a little different from each other. You may still find this a little confusing. So let me take this a little further, all right? A lot of people out there, personally branded people, are popular for their work. But when you speak to their staff members or get that inside story or a wee nugget from their lives, you will realize as people, as real life personalities, they may be arrogant or prudish or show lack of compassion or may not even be as social as they appear to be when they are representing their brand. So this concept may pop into your head and you might be thinking of some celebrities. So let me elaborate with celebrities. It's an easy way to understand personal branding. Although celebrities aren't the only personal brands around us, you look at people, motivational speakers, sports persons, influencers these days, industrialists, take an Elon Musk, like I mentioned in the earlier episode, or a Cristiano Ronaldo. That's how personal brands are built. So it is to do with what you do, but it's also how you built your integrity around what you do. So let me give you again quickly the example of celebrities here. Do you remember Heath Ledger? Heath Ledger was so famous for being the notorious Joker in Batman. And you want to love and hate that character. That's the character he's playing. But his actual personality was so true. It was so sweet. His fans loved him. His colleagues loved him. And people had lovely things to say about him. That's the difference. He played a part which showed something else about him, but he actually was very different as a human being. And that showed his personality traits. Similarly, I don't know if you heard this, but last year there was this rumor doing rounds about, you know, stories of Ellen DeGeneres, whose entire personal brand is built on being kind. Literally, that's what made her the personal brand she is today. But accounts about her actual behavior with people, or tales from behind the scenes and her crew, they spoke otherwise, didn't they? Who's to tell, really? And that's exactly the point. We don't know people in their personality, in their zone. You probably resonate with their personal brand. You can't tell if they are positive or encouraging or arrogant or humble. You can't really put qualities to their personality. You may be wrong about that, but you can put qualities to their offerings. That's the difference. Literally, what they bring to the table is what you're putting into perspective here. Your personality surely does enhance your personal brand, and it is so important. But yet, they aren't the same things. So, you might want to think about that. Personality is how you reflect inside out, whereas personal brand is how you reflect outside in. Having said that, one thing you must consider for sure. It's the most beautiful synergy when a really strong, good, positive, and impactful personality reflects in their personal brand. There is nothing more real, more authentic, and more honest than that. So while building your personal brand, you might want to consider developing a healthy, confident personality as well. And this makes it a great opportunity to do just that. Meanwhile, this is your life. So you do what you love and you do it often. And if you don't like something, go ahead and change it. I'll see you next week with another manifesto. Thank you for tuning in to The Life Manifesto with me, Zarina. If you find the show useful, then please share it with your friends, family, and co-workers. You never know. You may just help someone become the best version of themselves. And if you want to align your life with some signature masterclasses, certification courses, and live sessions with me, go check out and download my app, Life Manifesto with Zarina Poonawalla, available on Play Store or Apple Store. And if you have any suggestions or anything that you would like to share with me, get in touch with me on my social media handles. I am at Zarina Poonawalla on Instagram and LinkedIn, and at Zarina Speaks on Twitter. See you in the next episode.
Hey, everybody, it's been another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. On The Last Brand Standing, apparel brands are at war. It's Manyavar versus Raymond's this time. Anupam and Ambi introduce us to their origin stories and how a new brand like Manyavar took on Raymond's, an established giant. On Misconduct, Raghavi and Nisha tell us the story of the mythological Kanagi's personal trials and tribulations and how she finally snapped and burned down an entire city. On Nankari, Sadaf and Archit discuss superfoods, nutrition, and bust some food myths from the internet with the help of Dr. Nandita Iyer, author and food blogger. On GBCD with Farad and Sunetra, we discuss C4 conflicts, as being different is difficult. It's definitely more complicated, especially when you're dealing with inferiority and superiority complexes. Do check this episode out for a great discussion on this. And on Smarter with Sid, Siddharth tells us why the Michelin star experience is consumed as a story and woven into the brand experience. Do follow us on social media. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And remember, if you're enjoying this show or any of our other shows for that matter, please do tell a friend. That is the most helpful thing that you could do to help us out. And finally, this week, we'd like to thank our sponsors on the network, Cred, Bank of Baroda, Quarter, CoinSwitch, Kuber, and Intel vPro. We really do appreciate the support. This is what makes it possible.
Working Monday to Friday, glued to your chair, making you feel dull? Worry not. Get your 5-minute weekly dose of travel around the world with Postcards from Nowhere. Join me every Thursday as I explore the strange, obscure, and fascinating parts of the world and bring out facets of travel you may not have thought of before. You can find us on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from.